Today we will discuss about the spleen. This is the spleen. It is a hemolymphatic organs. Because during the fetal life it produces the erythrocytes, and in adult life it produces the remove the old epithet, old RBC, which is hemolysis, and it remove. So it has a mainly it is an intraperitoneal organ which is situated into the left hypochondrium. Normally anterior end it is directed downwards, forwards, and laterally. It is directed downwards, forwards, and laterally, and this surface it is called the diaphragmatic surface, or it is also called the post-diaphragmatic surface, and this whole surface it is called the visceral surface, where there is a splenic vessels, either artery which is goes inside and vein it is come out, it is called the hilum of the spleen. So this is the hilum of the spleen. Anterior end comparatively broad than the posterior end. It is situated into the left hypochondrium, as well as medial end. It lies inside the epigastric region. So it is the intraperitoneal whole spleen which is covered by the peritoneum. So anterior end it is broad, posterior end which is narrow. It has a three border. Upper border it is the it is called the superior border, and always there is a presence of the notch, and it indicates that the spleen which is developed from the lobules, it developed from the lobules, and this one is the at the hilum. This is the border, it is called the intermediate border, and this is the lower border of the spleen. This is the lower border of the spleen. So it has a three border, inferior border or lower border, this is the intermediate border, and this is the upper border of the spleen. It has a two surface, medial surface, or it is called the visceral surface because it is related with the viscera, and this is the costodiaphragmatic surface. It is the two surface. Outer surface it is called the costodiaphragmatic surface, and inner surface it is called the visceral surface. Spleen which is directed downwards, forwards, and laterally inside the, it is the wedge shape. It is the here also you can see this is a spleen we have not removed, but it is a somewhat not ideal spleen. But if I will keep this spleen inside the body, then this is a spleen in this way. It is directed downwards, forwards, and laterally, and this is the medial end, and this is the lateral end of the spleen which is broad. This is the costodiaphragmatic surface, and this is a visceral surface. This is called the visceral surface. This is a superior border. This is the intermediate border, and this is a lower border. So spleen has a three borders: superior border, intermediate border, and inferior border. The organ related with the superior border and intermediate border, this here there is a fundus of the stomach. Between the intermediate border and lower border there is a relations of the left kidney, and anteriorly this part which is related with the splenic plexus of the colon, large intestine, and at the hilum near there is a tail of the pancreas. Spleen has a three ligament. One ligament which is not attached, it is called the phrenico-colic ligament, which supports to the spleen. One is the gastrosplenic ligament and one is the linorenal ligament. Linorenal ligament which contains the splenic vessels, tail of pancreas, and lymphatics. It is the content of the linorenal ligament, while the gastrosplenic ligament, it contains the short gastric vessels. Content of the linorenal ligament, it is the splenic vessels, lymphatics, sympathetic plexus, and also tail of the pancreas. So whenever you can remove the whenever there is any accident, there is a rupture of the spleen and it lead to the hemothorax, at that time you have to take the precautions of the dissect the linorenal ligament, and you have to take the precaution of the tail of pancreas, because the tail of pancreas, it contains a lot of abundant amount of the Langerhans cells, and it secretes the insulin and glucagon, so it regulates the glucose level of the body. So, and the another is the gastrosplenic ligament, it contains the short gastric vessels, And phrenicocolic ligament, which does not support to the spleen, but it does not attach to the spleen, but it supports to the spleen. It is a phrenicocolic ligament. So whenever there is an enlargement of the spleen, it does not go towards the left side into the left lumbar region, because the phrenicocolic ligament which supports. But the spleen, which is always enlarged towards the right iliac fossa, because on the left side there is a phrenicocolic ligament which prevents, goes downwards, so it enlarges towards the right side, so into the right, towards the right iliac fossa. Most commonly, enlargement of the spleen occur inside the India by the malaria. It is the most commonest cause for the enlargement of the spleen. It is also, there is a Kala Azar. There are many things which occur inside the spleen. You have to remember, there is a, in short, how to remember the spleen. One is thick. It is the Harris Dickton odd number you have to remember. One is thick, 3 inch broad, 5 inch length, 7 ounce in weight. 1 ounce barabar 30 grams, so nearly 200 grams in weight. It is related with the 9th, 10th and 11th ribs. It is under surface of the 9th, 10th and 11th ribs, and it is directed with the axis of the 10th ribs, axis of the 10th rib. So the function of the spleen, it is the, one is the phagocytosis. It has a, during the fetal life, it also produces the red blood cell. It is hemopoiesis and immune response, antigenic stimulations. There is an increase the lymphopoiesis. It is a cellular response and increase the formation of the plasma cells, and also old RBC, storage of the RBC, red blood cell can be stored inside the spleen and released into the circulation when needed, and it is a better mankind marked in animal than inside the man. So it is better inside the animal than the better inside marked inside the animal than the man. And there is a palpation of the skin, spleen. You can palpate by the normal spleen. It is not palpable, but it is enlarged 2 times. Then it is palpable under the right, turning the patient, palpated, turning the patient on the right side, and you can palpate on the left side. So it is normally twice enlargement of the spleen, it can be palpable. So this is about the spleen. You have to remember, once again, it has a 3 border, upper border, intermediate border and lower border. It has a 2 surface, costodiaphragmatic surface and visceral surface. Between the superior border and intermediate border, here there is a fundus of the stomach. Between the intermediate border and lower border, there is a presence of the left kidney. Anteriorly, there is a left caudic flexor of the colon, a large colon, and here there is at the hilum tail of the pancreas. And ligament of the spleen are the gastrosplenic, linorenal ligament and phrenicocolic ligament. Gastrosplenic ligament, it contains the short gastric vessels, and the linorenal ligament contains the splenic vessels, tail of the pancreas, sympathetic plexus and lymphatics. And phrenicocolic ligament, it does not support to the spleen, but it is does not attach to the spleen, but it gives the support of the spleen. Hope you enjoy the lecture of the spleen. Thank you.